Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the evolutionary algorithms. Today we will discuss about the MATLAB code of the cuckoo search algorithm and I will explain it step by step. So myself Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. You are most welcome to send me an email related to any query regarding this evolutionary algorithms MATLAB code, or else you can browse this channel, you can browse this link for more update videos on the MATLAB course. So what we do in this video is we will explain the step-by-step procedure of how to design the MATLAB code for the cuckoo search. So I have considered this function for the sake of the demonstration. So firstly, make sure that whatever the function you have, make sure that the function must be an unconstrained problem. Okay. So what you do is that if you have the this kind of the function, say minimize f of x subjected to some g of x is less than or equal to 0. So this is my constrained optimization problem. So you first convert this problem into the unconstrained optimization problem. So by using penalty function. So by using some penalty function, you can define some new function, say L or say capital F. This is nothing but my f of x plus lambda times of g of x. So this way you have to minimize this function fx subjected to some x is my lower bound and upper bound is there. So this is the way you can convert any constrained optimization problem into the unconstrained optimization problem. And then you can simply replace this function f of x in the entire MATLAB code with your own consider problem. And then the rest of the function will be designed as such. So make sure that whatever you have to change is only to change fx. So let's start with the cuckoo search. Just briefly overview what is a cuckoo search is. Cuckoo search is inspired from the behavior of the cuckoo and it is initially proposed by Zhang and Day in 2009, which is published in this title Cuckoo Search by Lewis Flight in Proceeding of the World Congress. So what is the Lewis Flights are there? In this cuckoo search, the new solution, that is x new, is updated with the help of the previous solution x, and this randn, this is a random number which lies from minus infinity to plus infinity. So n, what is the meaning of this n? Is it's a normally distributed. Okay, if you call as a simple randn in the MATLAB, so this is a random number which is lies between 0 and 1, but if you lies this, then it's any number which lies between this to this, and it is called as a normal distribution, while the c is defined like this way. So what is the s, what is the x is there? So this s is called as the step size. This is called as the steps, which is defined with the help of the, this is called as the Levy distribution. And u and v are nothing but the random numbers, which are variance. This is a sigma, u is a variance. Okay, and this best is called as the best solution in the NSP. And while this procedure is called as the Levy distribution and so on. After forming this, we will replace some old best solutions with the help of some fractions, that is called as a PA. So how you design that? We will choose a random number. If random number is less than of this pre-assigned probability, then we will modify it. How you modify this probability, how you modify the solution is with the help of this equation, where D1 and D2 are the random numbers. So we will implement this phase into the MATLAB program. So I will design this MATLAB phases into the three parts. First one is the Lewis flies, replace them, and then greedy selection. Now make sure that again I recall that you have to convert your constrained problem into the unconstrained problem in order to apply this cuckoo search MATLAB code. And if you remember that this is the same function that we have discussed in our previous MATLAB course. MATLAB code of the ABC algorithm, MATLAB code of the PSO, MATLAB code of the TLPO, which is also available in this YouTube, links are there. And if you find these more videos, you can simply click on this link. You will find all those MATLAB codes, including this one, in this link. Now let's start with the MATLAB code. We will design this MATLAB code in the seven phases. Remember these phases, that is a check bounce and perform greedy selection. These are the similar as that of the phase 4 and 5. While the others are here, what you can do in with your objective function is you can simply replace this with your own objective function. This you can replace with your own problem, and rest will be same. Rest will be exactly same as and so on. So let's see on the MATLAB window is there. So this is the MATLAB window. That's the cuckoo search code for the unconstrained optimization problem and so on. So you start with the format short and long RTRP. So look at that. So you start with here. Now in this function, you firstly define the dimension of the problem. So dimension is depending from the problem to problem. How many variables are there? Look at that. There are the two variables are there. So I define the first phase D as my dimension of the problem. What is the LB is minus 5, minus 5. I use as a minus 5, minus 5. This first one is the random variable, is the lower bound for the x1. This is for the x2. If you have some problem f of x which consists of the three random variables, if I say L, this is my 4, x2 is lies between this, and minus 3 is lies between this. Okay, then in that case, your LB will be lower bound 0. Second variable is 2, then third is minus 3. And similarly for the upper variable, 4, 3 and 7b. So make sure that the first one is for the x1, second is for the x2, third is for the x3. Now in this case, my L lower bound is minus 5 and plus 5. And UB is my upper bound. So plus 5, plus 5. So look at that, it's a plus 5 for the x1, plus 5 for the x2. I define the population size as a 20. You can change to be a 100, you can change to be 200 and so on. This PA, that is a 1 by 4 probability of for the aligns, and maximum iteration I can set to be a 100. You can change to be a 500, you can change to be a 700 as per your convenience. So what you can do is you can simply copy this text and paste in your MATLAB file. So I can copy this file and paste in the MATLAB file. This is the same. You can change this to be 100 if you want. Okay, you can change to be 50 if you want. There is no problem about that. So I can change to be 20. Now what you can do is, now you can define the objective functions. So look at that. My objective function is this. Now you can define the objective function. So create this file. Look at that. My objective function is f. So I call as fns. How many variables I have there? X1 and x2. So I can call as x1 and x2. If you have the x3 also, you can define like this way. X3, 3, x4 and so on. Now you can write this, I save as a function out, so you can save out, x1 square, so this is x1 square minus x1, x2, plus x2 square, plus 2x1, plus and then so on. Once you are writing this, make sure that you are not writing this in here, okay? You have to write this file in the separate program, look at that. And once you save this file, you can save this file with the name, this one, fns, so look at that. You have to save the file with the name fns, whatever you have written here, fns.m, in the same folder. This is the most important. In the same program where your main program run. What is the main program is? Where you have saved this file. Okay. So you have to save this file. Look at that. I have saved, look at, I have saved fns and cs code in the same folder. Okay. Now what you can do is, now I can start the code. So now you can generate the initial population. How you generate the initial population is, that is a lower plus random into upper minus lower. I use the lower as a LB. Random is RAND, upper minus lower. So I have to define this with respect to the population size. So I use the two loop. One for I varies from 1 to n. N is my population size. D is my dimension. So I can copy this file. You can simply copy this text from here to here. And this is my f of x function evaluation. So I can copy this file and paste here. So look at that. If I run the file, so look at that. What will be the output? So I have saved the value as a nest. Look at that. These are my 20 values are there. All are lies between minus 5 to 5. And if you want to see the function fx value, so you can see that if I just write, these are my function values. For example, if you substitute x1 this, x2 this, the function values are 7 point something. Now, once you are defining this, what you do, you can define this sigma u with the help of this. Beta is a fixed quantity, it's a 3 by 2, that is a 1.5, you can write 1.5. You can write this expression directly in the MATLAB. What is that? This is the gamma. So look at that, gamma of 1 plus beta. I can write this as gamma 1 plus beta. Multiply sine, this is a sine. Pi is denoted as a pi, beta by 2, divided by this whole quantity I have used writing here. This power 1 divided by beta. So this is the bracket, this is the starting bracket and this is the this is look at that this is the bracket okay this is the bracket and this is for the 1 by beta so I can simply write this file I can simply copy from here and paste at this so you can see if I run the file so look at that what are the values of the sigma this is 6966 so the value of this is computed as 6966 now once you are defining this now I can start with the main program so I can start with the loop for iteration 1 to 1 iteration maximum so what you do is your task is to find this one so in order to this you need this x you need to find this s you need this x you need this and this these four quantities are there so what is how firstly how you find the best since my problem is the minimization so you firstly find the minimum of the fx so this fnv is the function value ind is the index value and out of these function values you find the best as minimum among them what is the meaning is if I just copy these values are here okay so if I just copy this value at here okay and if I just run the value so look at that my best value is here this is the best value among this among all these value which one is the minimum is it can calculated as this way now what you can do is now your task is to find x so for that you have to start from the loop 1 to the pop you can instead of this you can write also as n if you want so firstly I can use you can use s as a nest of the first value now you can use the s value so you can use this u is nothing but my random n so you can use a random n of size of the s whatever the size is there multiply by sigma what is the v is random of n what is the step this s this I just denoted as my step so u divided by v so this is u divided by absolute of v so absolute of v power 1 by beta once you are writing this then you can define the x nu as x so this is my x plus r a and d random of size multiply with the 0.01 s is denoted as my step and x minus x best so I can copy this file if you look at that if I just copy this file from here so you will see what will happen so if I just copy here okay if I run the file look at that what are the values of the x nu look at that the values of the x nu are here okay if you run again because it's a random number if I just run the again then x nu are here okay so it may be that sometime its values are away from look at that if you want to find the r a and d n look at that every time its numbers are changes okay every time its number are changes it can be more than 1 it can be less than 1 it can be negative and so on so what you can do is that so since this x nu it can be lies out it what is my domain is minus 5 to 5 now you can check whether it lies between minus 5 to 5 you have to check their bounds what is the meaning is we have to check whatever you have to calculated x nu check if it is greater than of the 5 5 is my upper bound then we can set as the upper bound else if it is less than of the lower bound if it is out of the bound minus 5 you can set as the new lower bound so I can simply again copy this text from here I can simply check this this text from check bounds okay and I can paste here okay you can simply copy this text you can write this text in your MATLAB file now we will perform the greedy selection what is the greedy selection is we will check whether this new updated solution is better or not so we will check this equation what is the f nu is function value at x nu so we will calculate this f nu as here now since my problem is minimization so we want this as a minimum we can compare this with the f of x of this if this satisfied we can update this x nu with the previous we can update with this new with this one and finally we can end the loop and this is the end for the for loop so look at that what will happen is if I just perform the greedy selection I can copy this one okay so if I just copy this and so on so what is the meaning is that you have to update the value of so this is the updated value and these are the new values are there. Now, once you are performing this value, now we will enter into the second phase B. What is that? We have to replace this. Now, this is the most important phase. How you choose? You firstly choose the random number. Then you have to check this condition. And then you have to perform this one. So, how you choose this one? Look at that. I can firstly, how you choose this random number is? You can choose, look at that. This is not the normally distributed. This is a simple random. So, you can choose this random. Okay, this is my R. So, you have to check whether R is less than of the PA or not. So, look at that. If I just type this equation in the MATLAB, so what will happen? Okay. So, look at that. I can copy this file so far. So, look at that. If I just copy this text and if I just paste here, look at that. What are the value of the K? Look at that. What is the meaning of this? Look at that. What is my nest is this. And what is my K is this. What is my PA is 0.25. If it choose any random number, it choose any random number and check whether it's less than of the PA. If yes, then it put 1, otherwise 0. Now, if it is less than of, if this condition satisfy, we will select this new position. How we select this new position is based on this. What is that? This is a random number. It's a random integer. So, we will use this random perm command. What is this meaning? Look at that. If I just write here random rand perm of 3, it means it takes the 3 numbers randomly. Look at that. It take 2, 3, 1, random of 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay. If I choose random perm 5, that is a permutation of the 5 numbers are there. It can be any one of position. Look at that. If I just again write, it's 1, 2, 4, 5, 3. If I just write again, then 1, 2, 5, 3, 4. So it means if you choose 1, 2, 3, 4, if I choose random perm 4, it means the position, it can be like this way, it can be like this way, it can be like this way, and so on. So this is a random number from this. So look at that. What is the meaning is? RAND. Okay, this is a rand. Multiply. This is a multiply. X. X is denoted as nest. D1. So D1 is the any number which is random. Okay, random integers. So again, minus. It's a minus random of this. So this is a step size K. Now what you do is, now you can add them. So how you add them? Nest plus this answer is denoted as my step size K. Now this equation is applicable only for those values which satisfy these equations. So how you satisfy this equation is K. So you can simply multiply K. Okay. So look at that. If I just copy this text again, I can copy this text again from here and paste this one. Okay. Now you have computed this new nest. Now again check the bounds. How you check the bound is whether this, again this is the same rule be. So I call as X new nest because I save this value as a new nest. You can save this value new nest as S. Now check whether this is S is my up greater than of the upper bound. If S is less than of the upper bound, then you can replace this S with the new nest again. So if I just copy this check the bounds again. Okay, so you can check the bound here again. So what you can do is, after finding that, you will get this. Now you can perform the greedy selection again. So what is the F new is? Again, now you can calculate this value at this, or you can calculate as S. Check whether this is less than of the Fx. I have used the loop double I. So this, if it is so, then this and so on. So I can again, you can simply copy this one from this and paste here. Okay, so now this is the phase and is there. So now this process is repeated for again and again. So now finally we will memorize the best position so far. So what we have, we will save this value, updated value as fx. We will calculate the, since my problem is minimization, you can save the minimum of fx as this is the optimal value. This is the optimal index. So the corresponding index is, if look at that, if I just run the file. Okay, so if I run the file, okay, so look at that. If I just run the file, I got this fx is there. Okay, out of this fx, which one is the minimum? So in order to find this minimum, so I can simply copy this value. I can simply copy this command. Okay, and if I just paste here, look at that. What is the meaning is? So look at that. If I have this fx, then I just simply say opt value opt index of minimum of fx. What is the meaning is? Look at that, opt-ind, it will give you 11th. It means the minimum value is occurring at the 11th position. Look at that, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So you can see that minus 6.33 is the minimum among all less. Yes. Okay. And last one is also, there is the same value is there. So once you will save, get this minimum value, we can store this optimal value, that is a function, objective function value, as best fx, best solution value as the best x. Now you can run the file. This is with respect to the each iteration. Now you can display the iteration. We will run the file. We will show you. And finally, we can plot the command and so on. Once you will plot this, your graph will look like say this. Look at that. This is a convergence graph. So look at that. Now, if I just run the file, if I just run the file again, fully, so what will happen? So look at that. If you run the file, then look at that. This is the graph, and look at that in the back side. At the each iteration, you will get the required answer. At the first iteration, the best solution is this. At the second iteration, the best solution is this, and so on. Okay. So if you want again, you can see that I can drag it here. If I just run it again, look at that. Iteration wise, you can plot them. Okay. And the best graph is lookalike, say this one. Okay, so this is the simple programming of the MATLAB. So if you want to see the whole program, I can maximize it. You can see from the starting. So firstly, you have to define this. Define the objective function. This is the objective function. And this is the only phase you can change it. You can replace this FNS. You can change this file with your own objective function. After defining this, you can generate the population and then start with the iterations, start with the Lewis flyest, look at this command, then check the bound. If you check the bound, then perform the greedy selection. Then you will replace some best value with the help of the PA. Again, check the bound. This perform the greedy selection. Finally, memorize the best solution. Print the solution. Finally, output and so on. So if I just one more time, if I just run the file, look at this is the out of the 100 runs, and look at this is the optimal convergence versus iteration graph. So if you still feel any doubt, you can ask me at any time. Otherwise, you can click on this. You can find the MATLAB code of the PSO, MATLAB code of the ABC, and other videos are there. We will meet in the next lecture that working on this gravitational search algorithms, BBO, or even the SGO and other algorithms are there. Till then, you can subscribe the channel. If you like this video, you can share with your friends. Till then, happy learning. Best of luck.